Hello everyone, today we have a simple quiz on soldering process. So let's see the first one. The soldering process is done below. So soldering is done below which temperature? So you must remember, it is done below 450 degrees centigrade. The melting point of filler material is very less and that's why it is done below 450 degrees centigrade. Next we have, soldering joints are not suitable for high or low temperature application because of high or low melting point of filler metal. So we know that filler metal have very low melting point, so here it should be low melting point. And if the filler metal has low melting point, then the soldered joint will not be suitable for high temperature services or high temperature application. So here it should be, it is not suitable for high temperature application. Let's see the next one. It is because when the soldered joint will be, you know, subjected to high temperature, then the filler material of that joint will be, you know, molten down and it will get melted and, you know, the material will fail. Okay. Next, a soldered joint is weaker or stronger than braced joint. So we know that brazing basically that do not involve any capillary action, but soldering involves capillary action, and in the brazing joint gap is more, okay, and joint design for brazing welding is similar to that of oxyacetylene gas welding, and filler metal, you know, enters by gravity in the brazing, and filler metal generally used is brass with zinc content up to 40%. So brazing joint is stronger, so soldered joint is weaker than a brazed joint, so it will be weaker than a brazed joint. Let's see the next. Next we have, a filler metal is melted and distributed by which action between the fraying surfaces? So in the soldering, there will be capillary action. That is very important. So filler metal is melted, okay, below 450 degrees centigrade, and it is distributed by capillary action. So it will be capillary action between the fraying surfaces. Okay. Next we have, a filler metal is known as, the filler metal in soldering is known as solder. So it is known as solder. Solder is being added to the joint and which distribute itself between the closely fitting parts by the capillary action. Let's see the next. Solder flux contains acidic or basic component that are gas in nature. So let's see, the solder flux basically contains acidic component in that. It will be acidic component, and acidic components are basically corrosive in nature. So solder flux are basically acidic, having the acidic component, and that are corrosive in nature. So due to this corrosive nature, okay, we have to clean the, you know, soldered part after soldering to remove any, you know, of this acidic, any unwanted acidic component. Okay, so we have to clean thoroughly after using this type of flux. Next we have, flux used for electrical soldering work. That is very important, and we have the flux known as rogene. That is rogene and rogene plus alcohol. Rogene plus, that are alcohol based fluxes that are used for electrical soldering work. And these fluxes are least active type flux. These are least active. One second. These fluxes are least active, and hence they are used for electrical soldering work. Okay. Next we have solders are alloy of. So solders are basically alloy of low melting point metals like lead and tin. Okay, so they are alloy of lead and tin. Next, the eutectic alloy, that is 62% tin and 38% lead, has highest or lowest melting point, and how much is that? So this eutectic composition has the lowest melting point. Okay, so it should be the lowest melting point, and that is 183 degrees centigrade. So it is 183 degrees centigrade. And the last one is, to improve the mechanical properties and temperature resistance, the solders alloying elements used are. So to improve the mechanical properties and temperature resistance, we generally use zinc, cadmium and silver in solder. So that's all about the soldering process. Thank you.